everyone and how they were doing back home. It was a time when, in a generalized way, we shared with one another a little bit of our personal lives, moms and dads, siblings, girlfriends, fiancés, and wives. This is how Glenn got to know who Teresa was, and that she was my fiancé waiting for me back home. Glenn always spoke kindly about his family. He spoke about his dad being in the military as an officer and always spoke respectfully of him. None of us ever really shared much detail about our home life. It was always in this general way. We didn't really talk much about our aspirations in life either. What profession we wanted to go into, dreams and such. We were 19-year-olds, 20-year-olds. And we felt, perhaps we felt, that it was presumptuous to think that far ahead when we were living moment to moment. I knew from our talks, Glenn and I, that commanding officers wanted Glenn to be a career soldier and go to officer school. He could easily have done that and been that. He would have made an excellent career soldier, an officer, but that's not where his heart was. In addition to having qualities of a great soldier, Glenn also had a good and generous heart. It was no surprise to me that he would later choose a career serving people and society in a different way. Glenn and I finished our tours at different times without fanfare and returned to the States. Like all returning combat veterans, there would be major adjustments to make and to try to pick up where we had left off. And I lost track. We lost track of each other for years, for several years. On my return to Houston, Teresa and I immediately got married and we transitioned back into civilian life. I got a job, returned to college, and we started a family. Several years went by before Glenn and I renewed our friendship. I don't recall exactly when, but about 20 years ago, one night, I received a phone call, and I couldn't believe who was on the other end of the phone. It was my old best friend, Glenn, who had tracked me down and found me through the internet. It was truly one of the best days of my life. Glenn and I stayed in touch over the next 20 years through phone calls, letters, email, and greeting cards. But 6 years ago, we talked and both of us agreed it was time to meet somewhere for a reunion. We chose Tulsa, Oklahoma. Roughly a halfway point between us. Teresa came with me and Jenna accompanied Glenn. Glenn and I were excited and elated to see each other again. We shared as if it had only been yesterday. Really. We shared as if it had only been yesterday since we last saw each other. I'm so glad that we took the time to do that. It was this simple reunion that provided a window for Glenn's family and mine for you to take a glimpse into the deep friendship that started in a faraway place and endured for nearly 50 years. Even with 1,000 miles between us. months ago, I was at home recovering from surgery. Myself and Jenna called me with the news that my best friend had gone home. And I believe he has. And I want to thank Jenna for not forgetting our friendship. Jenna also told me about her upcoming wedding plans to marry Adam and plans to have a celebration of a life memorial for Glenn. Jenna and Tracy followed up by sending me details for both events. It was truly a difficult decision whether to come to Jenna's wedding. I would have liked to have made both, but just finances. I had to choose only one. And I felt like this event here would be a proper honor to my friend Glenn. Actually, I was stunned and heavy-hearted for several days by the loss of my friend, but consoled that I would be coming here to honor him. And to the family, it was appropriate for you to choose Veterans Day to honor this great man and veteran. I would like to close by quoting from the Bible some verses that I believe give Glenn the proper honor from one good friend to another. From the book of Sirach, or Ecclesiasticus as it's called sometimes, chapter 6, verses 14 through 17, a faithful friend is a strong defense, and he that hath found one hath found the treasure. Nothing can be compared with a faithful friend, and no weight of gold and silver is able to countervail the goodness of his fidelity. A faithful friend is the medicine of life, and they that fear the Lord shall find him. He that feareth God shall likewise have good friendship, because according to him shall his friend be. And then finally from Proverbs chapter 17, verse 17. He that is a friend loveth at all times, and a brother is proved in distress. Thank you very much.